At last, you've arrived. Good, good. There is much to do, and every moment is critical. I'm Overseer Tremel. For decades, I've administered the trials that prove who is and is not worthy to join the Sith Order. The trials are a chance to weed out the weak. Those who face them either survive and become Sith, or die.
Mark my words. I am destined to be Sith.
It wasn't destiny that brought you here. Yes, you are here and ahead of schedule because of me. I expect you to obey. You face your trials, you serve me, and I will make you the most powerful acolyte here.
You had better be able to deliver that, Tremel.
Leave your doubt at the door. There's no room for it in here. And no time to waste. The trials themselves are difficult enough, but they are hardly the greatest threat you face. There's an acolyte here named Vemrin. He's your enemy, and he will try to kill you. We must prepare you.
Let him try. I'll destroy him.
With my guidance, someday you'll destroy all your enemies. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. The blade of lesser acolytes. You need a dominating weapon. In the tomb of Ajunta Paul, there's an old armory. A strong Sith warblade awaits you there. The tomb is thick with claw slugs. Deadly, savage creatures. Be speedy, but careful. They've been the end of many an acolyte.
If they lack the instinct to avoid me, I'll feed them their heads.
Once you acquire the warblade, I suggest you spend some time in the tomb bloodying it. Then come to me in my chambers in the academy.
Hey there, Acolyte. Hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you.
So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
You don't want to make me angry, Vemrin.
Believe it or not, I'm trying to keep you from getting killed. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, he might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill her and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Dulgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
I'm going to take what's yours, and then I'm going to kill you.
You have no idea the enemy you're making. Coming, Dulgus?
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other. But accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
I suppose this is sufficient.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my warblade, and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here. On her way to becoming Sith. If she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father. But I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her, she's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
Yeah, I hate him already. I look forward to ending his miserable existence.
If things go well, you will have that satisfaction someday. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, stop him yourself.
Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse. You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
You'd better send someone to clean up after me.
The slave pens are right there. They have mops. Go to the Academy prison. Speak to head jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners. Stop wasting time. Go to the jails, speak with the jailer, and pass judgment on the 3 prisoners waiting there.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk! If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jailer Nash. I run these cells and slave pits. You're the acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
Let's cut to the chase.
No skin off my rump. Now, these 3 prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
Show me to these soon-to-be-dead lowlifes.
Ah, fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me. Just do whatever you're gonna do.
Let me make this plain as day. If you don't cooperate, I will kill you.
I'm not afraid to die.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me!
Regale me with the details of your operation. What was your chosen form of murder?
I didn't kill him. I was caught before I could pull it off.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat? Which do you choose?
Her spirit is unbroken. Give this woman a weapon. She will fight for her life.
Whatever you say, kid.
This is stupid. Give me the damn sword.
I'm surprised. She faced her death well.
I spit on her remains.
Please, I am a fellow Sith. Grant me the same opportunity you afforded the assassin. I deserve a trial by combat. I beg you.
Pipe down, scum. You will speak when spoken to.
This part of waste is Davotek, once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I don't do charity work. Feel the weight of a weapon in your throat.
I die a disgrace.
Good. I won't have to look at his sad, weathered face anymore. Thank you.
And he won't have to look at yours either, Jailer.
Ah, Well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
Your ramblings are falling on deaf ears. Confess and the torture will stop.
Karipaka yang naya, harakam serik mera. Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
He's never wavered from that line, and the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
I don't care if he's innocent or not. Torture him enough and he'll confess.
Shut up, you fidgety fool. The decision's been made. Well, that's that. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices. Huh? What are you doing here? Sightseeing? Soak in the ambience, but stay out of the way.
Can't you find some slave to bother?
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solentz. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. Why did you grant her trial by combat?
She thought she was strong and special. It was the best way to teach her how impotent she is.
Little good the humbling will do with her dead. Never waste a potential resource, a trained assassin who demonstrated fortitude and amorality. The Empire could have utilized her skills. Now, Devotek, the former warrior, he wanted combat, but you struck him down. Perfect. The man was utterly useless.
I just did it for the fun of it.
Well, the instinct was spot on. Once something is used up, it should be eradicated. Lastly, the forger you sent back for more torture, even though he seemed innocent. A strong decision. Leave no stone unturned.
The ripple from even a tiny stone can flow a great distance.
Well, well, look who just turned deep and insightful. It's always best to know beyond any doubt. After all, what is one man's sanity or life versus the fate of the Empire? You're beginning to understand what it means to be Sith, but you're far from being able to impress Darth Barriss.
I'm not worried about impressing Barriss.
Impress him. Or die. Those are really the only choices you have. Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally. Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
Sounds like a good opportunity for violence.
Hold nothing back. This creature is doom itself. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
A fresh, young acolyte come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you?
I have no fear of dead things.
All fine and good, but lack of fear and genuine interest are not the same. This used to be a Tukata, the hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Your ego is overinflated.
I have gazed into the depths of the abyss and found revelations there others only dream of.
The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
I think it's time you got a life.
You judge me, yet have no understanding of my work. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
The galaxy is a harsh place.
You don't understand. I've lost a vital key to unlocking the dark side's true essence. You acolytes delve those tombs on your trials. You could hunt that Tukata for me and retrieve its perfect brain. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
Why not send your apprentice to recover this beast?
She's more suited to the laboratory than the tombs. She lacks your fire, I'm afraid. Ask Melora where to seek the Tukata and return to me when you have its brain. My apprentice, Melora, is standing over there. Ask her where to find the mutant Tukata that escaped.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
I was hoping this would keep me entertained.
Glad to know I'm not the only one who sees through my master's inane babbling. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
You're just scheming to get rid of your master.
I have a greater destiny than serving as a research assistant in this pathetic excuse for a laboratory. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I might be interested.
Perfect. Then we have an agreement. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest. Bring the mutant Tukata brain to me first, and I'll reward you. You'll find the beast in the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. Have you recovered the mutant Tukata brain yet? I'm eager to conclude the business we discussed.
Sorry, I'm still hunting the mutant Tukata.
The beast is twice the size of a normal Tukata. You're obviously not looking hard enough.
I'm running out of patience. Have you finally acquired the mutant Tukata brain, or should I send someone else?
I have what you asked for.
Ha! Wonderful! Let me see it.
Your beast died much too easily.
Then I release you back to the killing fields. May you find greater fulfillment there. You've done me a great service, but now I must continue my research. If there's nothing else?
Melora asked me to sabotage your experiment.
Is that so? Melora, if you can't show my work the appreciation it deserves, there's no place for you as my apprentice.
Wait, Master. It's a lie. I haven't betrayed you.
I know the truth when I hear it, Melora. I'm releasing you from my service. Eventually.
Master, please, stop! No!
My dear, the pain for you is only beginning. Take your reward and leave. Melora and I have much to discuss.
You should reward me for exposing this traitor.
Eliminating an enemy of the Sith Empire is its own reward. Go now. Leave me to my research. I have much work to do.
Congratulations. You've helped a delusional maniac remain in power.
I hope you're pleased with yourself.
Well, look who's here. Remember me?
You need to move out of my way.
I put myself in your way, buddy. On purpose. Notice anything interesting? No witnesses. No witnesses means no rules. No more shortcuts. No more special treatment. You're just going to be another dead failure on Korriban. No! Hold up, hold up. Look, I was wrong. What they're saying about you, totally true. So strong. I don't want to die.
I'm afraid it's a little late for begging. What will you give me to let you live?
Here, I've got a few credits. Take them.
Thanks for making that easy. You saved me the trouble of looting your corpse.
I failed you, Vemrin.
We must speak quickly, Acolyte. There isn't much time. I may have made a slight miscalculation. The beast of Mark Aragnos was a great source of dark energy here on Korriban. When it was slain, there was a tremor in the Force.
Darth Barriss felt that tremor and has become aware of you. He demands an audience.
Good. I've been waiting for this a long time.
After meeting him, you may find yourself wishing you had more time to prepare.
Barriss is a serious man, but a master of deception. Everything he does and says is calculated.
He will attempt to trip you up, test your nature, get to the heart of who you are. Always take him seriously. And I mean always.
You worry too much, Tremel.
I just wish we'd had a little more time. We might not speak again, Acolyte. You're the best chance of stopping Vemrin. If you fail, I doubt there will be another strong enough. Good luck.
Meet Darth Barriss in his chambers, and hurry. He won't take kindly to waiting.
Darth Barriss has summoned you. That's not something you wait to respond to. Go to his chambers now.
There, Tino. I believe that's the one.
Really? All right. Hey, you!
Careful, Tino.
Come on, I'm antsy for some action. You there? Are you the big shot they're all talking about? The one who's been personally summoned by Darth Barriss himself?
For your own good, curb your curiosity.
Please pardon my over-eager friend. It's just that we've heard so much about you.
And we want to get in good with you.
Tino, what my blunt partner here means is that if you need anything or anyone, say, dealt with, we'd like you to consider us.
She's talking about Vemrin. We'll kill him for you.
Sorry. I should have had Tino muzzled. So, what do you say? We know Vemrin tried to have you killed. Would you like him eliminated?
I'm preserving the pleasure for myself.
Far be it for us to rob you of such an experience, but consider this. There are rules. Acolytes are not to openly kill one another. Everyone knows of your rivalry. If you kill him, the Lords will presume your guilt.
But if Vemrin croaks while you get an alibi, people might be suspicious, but they won't be able to pin it on you. See?
I don't know. How can I be sure you can pull it off?
Let us prove ourselves to you. Spar with us, then decide if we have the skills to benefit you in this endeavor.
You should be warned. I will not hold back. There will be injuries.
Well, that's the chance we're willing to take. Come on, boys. Time to show our stuff.
Oh.
You still took all four of us apart. This changes everything. From what I hear, Vemrin's every bit your physical equal. If we can't even hold up sparring against you, we'll never be able to kill him.
Nonsense. I think you're up to the task.
You really think so? What does this mean, Fine?
It means Vemrin is a dead man, and we're going to have the most potent of allies.
Most of you will not return from this endeavor. If you die, you will be forgotten. If you give up, you will be killed. No, out of my sight.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You should. This is the end of the line for you, Clemeral. Just make sure you stay out of my way.
Look here, Vimran. I see the upstart, but no sign of Douglas.
Clemeral, Vimran, you have been dismissed.
Yes, Master.
I underestimated you by sending Douglas. It will not happen again.
Are you having trouble with Acolyte Vimran, supplicant?
If he insists on getting in my face like that, he's going to have trouble with me.
He has been hardened into a lethal machine. Vimran has paid his dues. He's fought a deck stacked against him to get here. You, on the other hand. Let me get a closer look at you. Yes, as I suspected. Overseer Tremel has done you and this academy a great disservice. Your warblade came early. Prisoners flown in for your convenience. Even a feast here on Korriban instead of off-world in the wild. The pacing of the trials is deliberate. Only full immersion over time produces results. Your mind is soft, unhoned, undisciplined.
I'll remember that. And someday you'll regret those words.
I wouldn't regret destroying you where you stand. The first month of trials should be dedicated to philosophy, conceptual tactics, understanding of the Sith Code. Recite the Sith Code for me, Acolyte, and explain its meaning in battle, war, and politics.
The only code I need to know is kill or be killed.
Your ability is undeniable. But your readiness and your understanding of the Sith way is woefully lacking. I am your master now. Tremel was becoming lax before you ever arrived. His unwillingness to adapt to the evolving Sith paradigm has become a liability. These are the actions of a traitor. Traitors are executed. I grant you immunity from punishment. Kill Tremel. And bring back his hand as proof.
It will be my extreme pleasure.
Now, leave. I'm sure Tremel is still in his chambers. Don't return until you've killed him. You continue to loiter. My eyes are already narrowing on you. Kill Tremel and bring back his hand immediately.
I didn't expect to see you again so soon. Has Barriss sent you back to me?
Today is my lucky day. Barriss granted my wish. I get to kill you now.
Then I have been outplayed. Barriss has the authority, but I did not think he would do something this overt. Either I die, or he forces me to kill you, and to destroy my own plan. A master stroke. Very well, you have your orders, Acolyte. Know that it gives me no pleasure to kill you.
What makes you so sure you're going to kill me?
You're strong, Acolyte, as strong as any I've seen come through the Academy. But you're not Sith yet. I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do. No. I'm amazed. I knew you were strong in the Force, but not like this. You're more than ready to challenge Vimran. Barriss won't be able to deny that now. He'll have the satisfaction of my death. But I die knowing my success. Go ahead. End this.
You are my greatest kill to date. I will rejoice in your blood.
Farewell, Acolyte. The purity of the Sith lies with you.
What's this? The Acolyte returns, and with a bloodied weapon. I assume this means Tremel is no more. Give me his hand. Here, take this one ring as a memento. Remembering the past can strengthen resolve and embolden the spirit. I am impressed you had the fortitude to destroy him. You know he thought of you as family. How did it feel to betray him?
It was a day I will long remember. I savored it completely.
Good. Feast on that. Not every kill will be as meaningful. You have taken your first step to understanding the Sith Code. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, we gain strength. Through strength, we gain power. Through power, we gain victory. And through victory, our chains are broken. The Force shall set us free. By embracing the code and destroying Tremel, you have freed yourself from his shackles and escaped his fate.
And now I'm bound by your shackles.
You'll find they are a marked improvement, with much greater potential range. Now, there are sacred ruins in the tomb of Tulak Horde. The ancient inscriptions that once adorned the walls of each ruin lie in pieces. You will venture through the entire tomb, search all of the ruins, and bring me a shard from each of these inscriptions. You will do this, or you will die. Vemran and my other acolytes have already been sent. There are no rules regarding how they secure the shards, and they will stop at nothing. Fight your way through the tomb of Tulak Horde in the Valley of the Dark Lords, and bring me the shards from each of the ruined shrines. You have yet to acquire the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde. I suggest you hasten yourself.
Acolyte, I come with a message. Lord Barriss can teach you the secrets of the Sith, but not all of the skills. For that, there are specialists in the Academy. Lord Barriss commands you to find them and improve your skills.
Your red skin is lovely.
It marks me as your better. For now and all time. Does that anger you? Then go learn how to kill me. You will find the best trainers in the Academy's archive. You are expected there shortly. Your trainers await.
You did it, didn't you? You got the shards from the tomb, and you're on your way back to Lord Barriss.
You need to move out of my way.
I'll take that as a yes. Stop! I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I tried to get through the tomb, but there were just too many Shyrak. I barely escaped. I figured better to ambush you and take your shards. But I see that's just as futile. Vemran is already inside with Barriss. All the other acolytes died. You were my only chance. Now, I'm doomed. I'll never become Sith. Unless I return with the shards, Barriss will have me killed.
I'll save Barriss the trouble of listening to your whimpering. Die!
The prodigal supplicant returns. And with all the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde. Superb. It seems your hopes have been dashed, Vemran.
Appearances can be deceptive.
Excuse Vemran, supplicant. He didn't take kindly to you turning those young acolytes on him, even though they were only untrained novices.
I hope he's not holding his breath for an apology. A blowhard like him might suffocate.
The tension is thick between you two. A great source of emotion to feed on. I wonder what will happen when it boils over. You both stand on the precipice of becoming Sith. But only one of you will have the opportunity to claim a special lightsaber and serve as my apprentice. I thought it would be you, Vemran, but I've changed my mind.
What? I've done everything you've asked. Better than any of the others. The honor should be mine.
Ignore Vemran, Lord Barriss. His world is crumbling around him.
today Vemran is every bit your equal. But the Force is stronger with you, Acolyte. And there is a power sleeping within you. It was a simple decision. Now, Vemran, go wait in my antechamber for your instructions. This instant. Now, I hope you fathom how fortunate you are to be singled out. If you become my apprentice, the galaxy will bend before you.
I can't wait to start killing.
The lightsaber you will seek is old and powerful. It is housed in a forbidden cavern in the tomb of Nagasado, where few Sith have ever set foot. Almost no one knows how to find the secret entrance. But there is a Twi'lek in the holding pens who was caught breaking in there. I hear she is quite willful. Take her and make her show you the entrance to the Forbidden Cave.
That sounds like fun. I will enjoy bending her to my will.
Yes, dominate her as you see fit. Other acolytes seeking to complete their trials are sent to the tomb, where Academy laws are waived. They will try to murder you. This test will determine if you become Sith. So bolster yourself. To set foot in the tomb of Nagasadao is to breathe in death itself. Don't make me regret selecting you to get the special lightsaber. Retrieve the Twi'lek from the slave pens and find the forbidden cave in the tomb of Nagasado.
Ouch! Give it a rest, will ya?
I'm getting my fill of fun while I still can, slave. As if on cue, look who's back. Word is you might become Lord Barriss's apprentice. Nice work if you can get it. So, I hear you'll be relieving me of this Twi'lek. She's a pain in the neck.
Ha! Who's a pain in the neck? I'm the one wearing a shock collar.
Consider that a going away present, Twi'lek. Seems you might be useful for something after all. This bruiser is taking you into the tomb where we caught you.
None of you can figure out how to activate the tomb statues to open the Forbidden Cavern, huh? You got some kind of business in that secret Sith chamber, do you?
Jayla, I think she needs a little more juice.
All right, one more for the road.
Enough!
Here, kid. Take the shock control color. I'll set it to a higher level. Use it enough. She'll show you the back door to her mother's house.
I suppose I can play tomb tour guide. A lot of work went into cracking that nut, but I did it once. I can do it again. So we're clear. I'm officially on strike when it comes to domestic duties.
Let's give this higher setting a test run.
Ow! Okay, that's worse. Stop! I'll take you to the unlocking points throughout the tomb, and then open the secret door for you. Just lead the way.
What do you want from me? I've done everything I can.
Hey, this is it. The secret entrance to the hidden cavern is in here. Just let me get my bearings.
Take your time, slave. Just have the entrance uncovered by the time I finish killing your new master.
You'll do nothing of the sort. Fitting that you meet your end in a tomb, Vemrin.
My passions run deeper than yours. I am the true essence of what it is to be Sith. My legacy has suffered long enough. After today, you will be forgotten. It ends here and now.
Nobody better mess with us now.
Becoming Barriss's apprentice was my destiny. Did I come this far and overcome such adversity, only to be proven unworthy?
You're wasting your time. Just die.
Wow. Nice work.
Speak when spoken to, slave.
Ow! Banthapoo! What was that for?
Just to put you in your place, so you don't forget your station.
Couldn't you have written a note? Sheesh. The secret entrance is right here. You're welcome.
Here's my thank you, slave. Choke on it.
Ah, sorry!
My father was a staunch traditionalist, and he was especially hard on me. But he's my blood. Did you think you could kill him and get away with it?
Who told you I killed your father?
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Come at me, and I will kill you too.
You'll rue the day you took his life. Attack!
You think you scare me?
I am beside myself. Not only did you get the Twi'lek to cooperate, but you completed the task and claimed the ancient lightsaber. Venran was not in my chamber as I instructed. I take it he sought to stop you and claim the ancient weapon as his own.
He did. Now his carcass feeds the tomb's beasts.
Bravo! I see you may indeed become one of the strongest Sith in the galaxy. Your trials are over. You are now my apprentice.
It took you long enough.
Mind your tone, my young initiate. This is only the beginning. With you as my right hand, we shall strike fear into the Empire's enemies.
I must convene with the Emperor and inform him of your progress. This shuttle pass will take you to Dromund Kos. Meet me at the Citadel there.
Tell the Emperor I said hello.
I'm sure he'll be thrilled. Take the Twi'lek slave as my gift. Do with her as you wish. If she'll be of use, by all means take her with you to Dromund Kos.
Kigamayamak Nulilak Apajam Kamgam Amka Nemnang Ampa Nemnang Memua Inok Bomogala Apayang Nelama Imi Amka Amgap.
Sounds like a plan.
Nanekari Maraka Amkam Jauklibik Memarknebab Karahika.
We'll tell the captain that I'll be back on the bridge as soon as I've done his errand.
Yes, sir.
Good to have you aboard. I'm Lieutenant Silas, second in command of the Black Talon. We're your ride to Dromund Kos.
Is there a reason your captain isn't bothering to greet me?
We may only be a transport, but someone needs to stay on the bridge, and the captain prefers to keep to himself. On our present course, we should arrive at the capital within a day. Won't be any trouble. I should also add on behalf of everyone, it's an honor to service the Sith and the Korriban Academy. Consider yourself our guest.
You should consider yourself fortunate.
Understood, my lord. I won't keep you further. When we arrive in the Dromund system, I'll have you informed. In the meantime, your droid's in the conference room. We picked it up with the upgrades from Geonosis. When we docked here, it mentioned your name.
If my droid's waiting, then I should see what it wants.
Feel free to bother the crew if you need anything else. I'll be on the bridge. And you, soldier, when you're done playing honor guard, get back to your post. This isn't a luxury yacht.
Yes, sir.
Identity confirmed. Good day. I'm Advanced Protocol Unit NRO2. My functions are diplomacy, translation, manslaughter, and calumniation. I have an urgent message for you from my master. Please stand by for delivery.
What makes you think I care what your master has to say?
I am certain you will be interested. Anyone traveling through Imperial space must listen to my master. This is Unit NRO2 to Grand Moff Kilrin. You are now in contact with the Black Talon.
Well, sir, I am. And it seems you've brought me just the person I've been looking for. My name is Rikus Kilrin. I'm commander of the 5th Fleet, second to the Minister of War, and my personal favorite, the so-called Butcher of Coruscant.
Something wrong with a hologram, or is your face supposed to look like that?
The scars. They're an old gift from a Jedi friend. I barely notice them anymore. 6 hours ago, the Republic engaged in an illegal border skirmish on the edges of Imperial territory. One enemy warship escaped. That warship, the Brentel Star, is carrying a passenger of vital strategic importance. Yours is the only vessel placed to intercept.
I think you're out of luck, then.
I don't believe you're right. Let me explain. The warship's passenger is codenamed the General. We don't know his identity, but the Republic believes he possesses military secrets, our military secrets. I trust the reports. The General must be captured or killed. Captain Orzik, the man commanding your transport, doesn't share my enthusiasm. He's disobeyed my orders to attack. Feel free to show him what the Empire does to cowards. Then commandeer his ship, find the Brentel Star, and deal with the General.
Right now, I'm more interested in getting to Dromund Kos.
Oh, I can sympathize. But I'm sure I can convince Darth Barriss to forgive a bit of tardiness. The General will be dead or in custody by day's end. If he's not, I assure you, your ship will never reach port.
I will lead the way to the bridge. Once Captain Orsic is deposed and our hijacking is complete, we may proceed to the Brentel Star. Excellent. Then I will proceed.
move aside immediately. Halt! My lord, this is a restricted area. Captain Orzik's command. You'll have to leave immediately.
I suggest you back off.
Halt! My lord, this is a restricted area. Captain Orzik's command. You'll have to leave immediately.
Your life is about to end.
Blasters out! Attack! Attack!
We must proceed to the bridge immediately.
Nobody better mess with us now.
If you are concerned about the loss of life, I assure you, the deaths of all injured crew members will be strategically insignificant. All Marines have been neutralized, scanning for additional threats.
What's going on? Sir, stay calm, Ensign. Everyone stay calm.
No threats found. The bridge is now secure.
Cooperate or die.
Hands off the consoles. We're all listening, my lord.
I can handle this, Lieutenant. I'm Captain Revenant Orzik. I'm pretty sure I know what this is about. For the record, I take complete responsibility for my actions.
Captain Orzik, I'm told you disobeyed a direct order from Grand Moff Kilran.
Yes, I had no idea he'd respond this brutally. He must want the Brentel Star's passenger pretty badly. Maybe he just hates me. The Black Talon would be destroyed chasing a battleship. I've fought in the war before and I'll fight again, but I don't do suicide missions.
Suicide was deciding you could ignore your superiors.
The captain's dead! The captain's dead! Shut up! You have our attention, my lord. What would you have us do?
Let this be a lesson. Your only hope for survival is complete and utter loyalty.
Yes, my lord.
Yes, my lord.
In accordance with Article 27A of the Imperial Code of Military Conduct, command of this vessel has been lawfully transferred. New orders are being downloaded to your consoles. Priority 1, intercept the Brentel Star.
Picara, do as the droid says and prepare to jump to light speed.
Emerging from hyperspace now. One Thranta-class warship on the scanners, powering up
Enemy is firing. Turbo lasers, missiles, and what looks like transport pods. I'm not sure.
The pods are a distraction. Return fire. Aim for their power generators. So long as they're damaged, we're not. We have the advantage.
Lieutenant. Captain Silas, sir. Engineering is reporting blaster fire. They just cut out.
If we weren't in the middle of battle, I'd kill you for incompetence.
Damn it. It must be some sort of boarding action. If they're in engineering, they could destroy this ship. With due respect, I recommend you lend a hand down there.
I'll sleepwalk through it.
I'll notify security.
And don't worry. We won't let those Republic scum get away. I respectfully suggest you start dealing with our invaders.
I'm doing my best, I swear.
I won't get in your way. I'm just doing my duty.
Additional security forces are needed in the cargo area to enforce containment measures. Please
respond. Anyone read me? This is engineering. We have an emergency. Please respond. The droids locked us out of the control room. They're sabotaging the engine.
Through. All better.
Lieutenant Silas, if you can hear this, please return to the bridge. We need you.
Damage reports from all decks. We're holding together, sir, but I don't know for how long.
Make sure it's long enough, Ensign. Your life and career are at stake.
Please stand alert. Grand Moff Gilran's representative has returned.
Congratulations, my lord. Security reports that the sabotage droids have been destroyed.
Bring me up to speed.
Oh, please. Please don't kill us.
Shut up, Ensign, or I'll kill you myself. We've penetrated the Brentel Star's outer defenses. Their next assault won't come until we enter fighter range. Another minute, maybe two.
Transmission coming in. Long range. It's a message, but it's not from the Brentel Star.
I don't appreciate dramatic pauses.
I'll patch the message through immediately.
This is Jedi Grandmaster Satil Shan hailing unidentified Imperial vessel. I'm en route to your location with 16 Republic vessels. I'm asking you to retreat before more lives are lost.
Disregard the transmission. Continue closing on the Brentel Star.
Understood. Maintaining course and speed.
The Brentel Star is under my protection. Our convoy was ambushed and I sent the Star ahead. We will reunite. I just crippled 3 Imperial dreadnoughts. I don't wish to destroy you. The peace between Republic and Empire is fragile enough already.
Fragile enough to be crushed like glass, the same way I'll crush you.
Your base aggression serves no one, not even your empire. Incidents like this are happening across the galaxy, but only because we let them. Leave the Brentel Star to me. If you don't, then may the Force be with you. Because the men and women aboard that ship can hold you off until we arrive, and you will be defeated.
Do I have to kill you to get you to stop talking?
You've made yourself clear. But I suggest you prepare to face a Jedi. And you may want to consider what that means.
Entering fighter range. The Brentel Star is launching its first squadron.
All right. Now we're close enough to fly in and send a raiding party. I assume you're going.
Now you'll see what a Sith is capable of.
Before you go, you should know something. Most of the Marines will back you up, but we had to execute a few for refusing to fight.
They were terrified after what happened to the captain. They panicked.
They're dead now, anyway.
We did retrieve their equipment. It's yours. We're doing our very best to serve you, I swear.
Find some self-respect, worm.
Ignore him. I'll make sure he doesn't trouble you in the future.
I advise that you proceed to the shuttle bay. The flight to the Brentel Star may be hazardous, but Grand Moff Gilran has complete faith in your abilities.
The Brentel Star's waiting. We can't keep them busy forever.
This is Protocol Unit NRO2. I hope you're receiving this message clearly, and that your flight was free of incident. Please hold for Security Coordinator Ensign Brukhara.
The Marines are on their way. They'll follow you in and hold each junction you secure. Try not to take too long. We're not a military ship. What you have is all you're getting.
I don't need an army. I can handle this myself.
Yes, but... I understand.
I have been scanning the Brentel Star's communications, and security forces appear to be moving to protect the escape pods. It is extremely likely that the crew is attempting to evacuate the General. You must retrieve or eliminate him before he escapes.
I don't need a droid telling me how to do things.
Understood. I am simply looking after Grand Moff Gilran's interests. I will be in contact if the situation changes. Proceed to assault all defense points between you and the target.
All security forces, prepare to fire!
You're speaking to a Special Forces Commander, Meat. Show some respect. So, you think you're tough meat? Ha! Part of me was hoping you'd try to board this ship.
All better.
Thank you.
Brental Star! Attack! For the Republic!
Escape pods aren't far now. You can make it on your own, General.
And what about you?
I will face my destiny. Go now, my friend. Halt where you are. I am Yadira Ban, Padawan of the Jedi Order. I was sent to protect the General, and you will not pass.
I'm going to kill you, lady.
I will not fall to one such as you! I will not! You may run, or you may stand your ground, but you'll go no farther. You aren't going to win this. I swear it. You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
All better.
You aren't going to win this. I swear it. You aren't going to win this. I swear it.
You can put aside your weapons. I won't try to run. Besides, I doubt I'd make it to an escape pod without my intestines spilling out.
I might just spill your intestines myself. I don't need you alive.
I'm well aware of Imperial policy regarding my kind. I was a general in the Imperial military service. Did they tell you that when they sent you here? Did they even know?
Believe whatever you want. It doesn't change your fate.
If you knew what I knew, you'd understand. If you'd heard what both sides are plotting, you wouldn't be eager to restart this war. They're building doomsday weapons, shields that envelop planets, missiles that darken suns. Republic and Empire are planning to raise worlds, annihilate civilizations. It will be unlike anything the galaxy's seen since the Great Hyperspace War. And it's too late to stop it. The so-called peace is already lost.
There will be bloodshed on a massive scale. And I will be part of it.
At the start, yes. But you won't survive. None of us will. You have me then? Me, my stomach full of blood, and my implant full of cybernetic secrets and stolen plans. What will you do?
You're no use to me alive.
So be it. We're all as good as dead anyway.
This is Protocol Unit NRO2. If you are receiving this message, I urge you to return to the Black Talon as quickly as possible.
Explain yourself. What's going on?
There has been an incident aboard the bridge. Your tactics have inspired...
Idiots! You'll get us all damn well killed!
Welcome back. I'm pleased to see that you have returned whole. I do apologize for the condition of the bridge. As I'd intended to explain earlier, there was an incident.
You'd better tell me what happened, or I'm going to be very unhappy.
Several of the crew were extremely agitated by your behavior. Ensign Hetter feared you might execute anyone who failed to contribute to the mission. A group of officers attempted to flee the ship before you returned. Lieutenant Silas objected, and a firefight broke out. There was a large number of casualties, but don't worry. I am fully capable of piloting the ship back to Drummond Kaas.
What do we move on to now?
Grand Moff Kilrin is eagerly awaiting your report. Shall I put him through?
By all means, go ahead.
Opening channel now.
Well, how fortunate I could reach my friends aboard the Black Talon. The droid's been keeping me appraised of your work, but I very much wanted to hear from you. How did the attack go?
What's to hear? I did what you wanted.
Please respond appropriately to the Grand Moff.
Please. I'm in good cheer. There's no need for poisonings tonight. You should be proud. This is only one of the many operations we're conducting across the galaxy. It's a new beginning to the war. The General was one of the greatest weapons the Republic had. A defector. And you've snatched him from enemy hands. I'll remember this, and I'll make sure you're rewarded.
Spread the word of my success.
I'll make sure your heroism is mentioned when I report to the other Moffs. But my words hardly matter. Soon you'll be joining us on the homeworld, and you can see for yourself what you've been fighting for. It should be inspiring. Enjoy the rest of your journey. Kilrin out.
We will be arriving on Drummond Kaas shortly. Please proceed to disembark.
You're the one, yes. Not like the scabs that exited the shuttle with you. You radiate power, Lord. I bow before you. I serve Lord Barriss. He sent me to meet his new apprentice, and I made sure I was here on time. I certainly did, yes indeed.
Barriss should have met me himself.
It is not my place to question the master. I'm just a slave who owes his every breath to the tolerance of Lord Barriss. He said to introduce you to Drummond Kaas, and I take that seriously.
Your breathing is now dependent on my tolerance as well.
Yes, my lord. I exist by your good grace. Lord Barriss ordered me to encourage you to explore Kaas City before reporting to him. Imperials maintain the order, but they won't bother you. When you're ready, Lord Barriss will meet you in his personal chambers. You will tell Lord Barriss I was good? Yes? That I served well?
Just get out of my sight.
Have I done something to offend? How may I make amends, Lord?
Your very existence offends me.
What did I do? No!
Wow. Didn't take you long to start the Drummond Kaas death toll.
Do you want to be the next addition?
I think I'll pass.
Not a minute too soon. Your timing is impeccable.
Did it just get considerably colder?
I see you decided to keep the slave. I hope she amuses you. I understand you killed my welcoming committee.
It had to be done. He taxed me.
Killing him has not angered me. With such a disagreeable weapon at my side, many will think twice before crossing me. Your responsibilities will mandate contact with my various minions. Meet my directives, and you may do as you will to anyone you encounter, adversary or ally.
Sounds liberating. The ability to kill anyone I want.
A lightsaber can only achieve so much, apprentice. The most powerful weapon in a Sith Master's arsenal is information. I have painstakingly built a vast network of spies and operatives embedded throughout the Sith, Republic, and Jedi alike. I have fingers, eyes, and ears everywhere.
You've successfully infiltrated the Jedi Order?
Yes. My operatives are completely undetected, and I wish to keep it that way. I track our enemy, weakening and influencing them from within, waiting to strike. You're my enforcer, deployed to protect my interests, intimidate my rivals, and destroy my enemies. It's time for your tenure to begin.
A military starship is touching down at the Kos City cargo port, delivering a vitally important prisoner to me. You will meet Commander Lanklin at Docking Bay 12 and make sure he and his men successfully offload this prisoner.
If you're sending me, you must be expecting trouble.
We must always assume that we are being plotted against, especially when the stakes are high.
The importance of this prisoner cannot be overstated. Go to the cargo port now and stay sharp. You are dismissed. Waste no time, apprentice. Meet Commander Lanklin in the cargo port and make sure he and his men successfully offload my prisoner. Go.
All right, man, let's hurry up and get this hunk of carbonite to its owner.
Captain Olivius.
Oh.
Oh, I didn't see you enter. Lord Barriss didn't need to send a welcoming party.
You're lucky I'm not an enemy, or you'd all be dead.
Forgive me, my lord, but this is the capital world of the Empire. My men and I have performed much more dangerous duties for Lord Barriss. The prisoner is frozen in carbonite, so he's not a flight risk. And this is friendly territory. Surely we're safe here.
There is no such thing as friendly territory.
No offense, my lord. That brand of paranoia may work for Lord Barriss, but I don't subscribe to it.
Which one of your men takes over after I kill you?
Please, my lord. There's no need for talk like that. I heed your point. Let's get this oversized block of ice to your master.
Not so fast. My master ordered that block of ice. So step away from the carbonite man, and no one ends up in a grave.
This is a private party.
Then consider it crashed. I'm here to relieve you of your burden. Whether that includes your own lives as well is up to you.
Looky, looky. If it ain't Slestak, your master be wanting the froze man to her. Too bad for you. It mine.
You two know each other.
To know Tumar is to hate Tumar.
That go true for you too, Slestak. If you don't flee, this be like killing two stone with one bird.
I'm such a fool. I'll never doubt Lord Barriss again. What do we do?
We kill them all.
I know you're Sith, stranger, but I think your bravado is ill-advised.
Me got ideas, Slestak. How about we play wishbone with the talker? Bigger half, get the spoils!
A truce, then. You stood a chance against one set of us, Sith. But even a master force user can't beat these odds.
Time to roll the dice, then. Attack!
Time for killing, boys!
You're good to go.
See more ambushes on the way. Maybe you can hold them off while my men and I make a run for it and deliver the prisoner to Lord Barriss.
Leave the fighting for real fighters.
Come on, man! Double time!
Lanklin informed me of the ambush at the cargo port. Apparently there are more eyes on us than even I thought.
I have felt a disturbance in the Force. It leaves doom imprinted on my dreams. A grave and mysterious threat that could bring down my entire power base. This frozen man is a top Republic agent captured while investigating my most deeply embedded spy on Nar Shaddaa. One of my invisibles. The Force grants me a vision of doom.
And immediately, my untraceable spy, who has left no footprints, no trail, is almost exposed. It makes me furious.
Instead of whining, do something about it?
Oh, I'll do something about it. One of the things that I do best. Torture. I must learn what tipped off the Republic agent. He is the key to uncovering the nature of this threat. Now, while I thaw the prisoner and painfully siphon every morsel of information I can from him, I have some concerns that require your special talents.
I'd like to stay and watch the torture, my lord.
Yuck. Please, no.
You can watch me torture the next prisoner. Go to the Imperial post in the jungles outside the city. Commander Pritch is stationed there. He has a seek and destroy task for you.
I don't take orders from lackeys.
Pritch is merely relaying information, apprentice. I must tend to the torturing of this miserable Republic agent.
Waste no time. I have more for you to do once this is complete. You are dismissed. Torturing this Republic operative requires privacy, apprentice. You need to meet with Commander Pritch in the jungle. Go now.
Commander Pritch at your service, my lord. Lord Barriss informed me you'd be paying us a visit. I'm prepared to offer full assistance.
News travels fast.
Lord Barriss is nothing if not efficient. Let me follow his lead and bring you up to speed. There's been much unrest in these parts recently, my lord, capped off by a violent slave revolt that has the surrounding jungles overrun with armed slaves.
You can't deal with upstart slaves?
The slaves have been giving the forces sent to deal with them fits. I'm not part of that duty, my lord. What no one knows is that Lord Barriss orchestrated the insurgents to disrupt one of his rivals, and he wants his involvement kept secret. Now the slave captains who led the revolt are threatening to expose Barriss's involvement unless they receive more potent weapons.
Slaves, they're never satisfied.
I'd just be happy if you took the stupid shock collar off.
But then I couldn't do this.
Fine! Forget I mentioned it!
I see you know how to handle slaves, my lord. You think they know better than to blackmail a Sith lord. Lord Barriss wants you to kill enough of the blackmailing slave captains to make the others lose their resolve.
I'll kill everyone I see.
Present company excluded. I hope.
Slaves are scattered throughout the area, but the captains tend to congregate near the unfinished Colossus. I'll wait here for your return.
Takes guts to sit here and wait, don't you think?
Not another word.
Lord, I still wait for you to kill enough of the slave captains to get them to stop blackmailing Lord Barriss. Ah, my lord, you've returned. I take it many slave captains have died this day.
Their next of kin won't be able to identify them.
I shudder to imagine their fate. I must stay, my lord. It's been inspiring watching you work.
Prostrate yourself elsewhere, Imperial.
I'm sorry if I've angered you. I'll inform Lord Barriss that the situation has been handled. Thanks to you, the slaves in the jungle are no longer a threat to Lord Barriss, my lord.
I don't care what you do. Break my bones, burn my flesh. I'll tell you nothing.
I will not be denied.
Go spit, you monster!
I didn't know bodies could bend like that. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Don't empty your stomach on my boots.
Ah, apprentice, you've returned. Commander Pritch confirmed that the slaves have been silenced. Good. I'm still trying to extract the information I crave from this Republic agent. He's much more resilient than anticipated.
I thought you said you were good at this.
Now is not a good time to test me, apprentice. Even as I brutalize him, I twist the force to keep him alive and feeling every sensation.
That is the cruelest thing I've ever heard.
I have another important task for you. It involves a renegade Sith Lord named Grathan, a particularly bothersome thorn in my side. Meet with my apprentice, Dreykul Ball. He's my covert operative in Gratham's compound. Ball claims to have made a key discovery.
I thought I might be your only apprentice. That makes Ball my rival.
Try to tolerate him long enough to get the details and conclude your business there. Gratham's presence is useful to me, so I don't want him killed, just crippled. Find out what Ball has discovered and do exactly as he instructs.
Too bad. I would love to kill a Sith Lord.
No doubt someday you will have your chance to try, one way or another. Now then, Republic wretch, where were we? Oh, yes. Tell me what I wish to know.
I won't be broken. Tell your master he's wasting his time.
I am busy with this prisoner. Go to Lord Grathan's compound and meet with my agent Drakil Bal.
You must be the operative Lord Barriss sent. I thought he'd choose a stealthy assassin, not some senseless savage.
Just tell me the situation here.
Fine. I'll rise above my discontent. For now, now listen. Lord Grathan is a rogue Sith who boldly defies the Dark Council. Locked away here, he's been untouchable. Lord Barriss wants to let Grathan know he can be reached. And after a year undercover, I've discovered the way. Lord Grathan has a son.
Maybe in another year you can find out his shoe size.
He wears boots, not shoes, smart mouth. I was assigned to find Grathan's weakness. He's kept his son a secret in order to protect him from his enemies. Grathan would be devastated if his only child and heir was dead. That would send a message.
Just tell me where he is. I will be the messenger.
You'll have to be more than a messenger. Grathan's kid is nearly 20 and strong with the Force. He's been trained in the ways of the Sith since birth. You'll have your hands full.
I'll fill my hands with his entrails.
My, how graphic. You're a true Vulgarian. Grathan's away on business. I managed to hack a special spike that will get you inside his private quarters. But first you're going to have to knock out Grathan's surveillance station so you aren't seen entering the quarters.
What do I care if I'm observed?
The surveillance system is also a sophisticated defense network. If you don't destroy the system before entering the private chambers, you'll never make it. All you have to do is locate the monitoring stations around the compound and, well, stick your lightsaber in them. Think you can handle that, brute?
Keep calling me names, Bor. You're playing with fire.
Is it so easy to get under your skin? That's all then. Destroy the monitoring stations, then get inside Grathan's private quarters. The son's name is Beelzlit. Find him and end him. I'll meet you back here when you're done. Try not to screw up.
I kinda like his attitude.
Thanks to your obvious intrusion, the whole place is stirred up. I'd hurry to Grathan's private quarters and off his son quick if I were you.
Mother, a stranger approaches.
You don't know the half of it, kid.
I am Sylvanta Grathan. How dare you enter my son's room uninvited? Who are you?
My name won't matter when you're dead.
You'll find I'm not so easily intimidated. My son is still an acolyte, but I am Sith. Beelzlit, take cover.
No, Mother! I stand at your side! Attack!
This always does the trick.
Enough. It's clear we are not your match. If we're to die, I must know. What have we done to deserve death?
I kill your son to wound your husband.
Mother, if I am the target, save yourself! I don't want to see you die!
My son, you must not sacrifice yourself for anyone, not even me. You must endure at all costs. Assassin, you've carved your way into the inner sanctum of Lord Grathan's compound, all to kill a boy. You are a breath away from the Master himself. Spare us, and I'll help you destroy Lord Grathan instead.
Those aren't my orders.
Beelzlit, run!
No, Mother. If I am to die, I die alongside you.
I'm surprised you survived. So is it done? Is Grathan's son dead?
You're a condescending windbag, Ball.
It's pretty easy to push your buttons, brute. Doesn't say much for Grathan's security forces if a clumsy clod like you was able to bang into his private chamber and off his son.
I find your empty chatter amusing.
You'll find my lightsaber a bit sobering. Killing the murderer of Grathan's son will solidify my cover here. Barriss can replace you easily.
Barriss will be needing a new spy. I'm going to enjoy killing you.
Though I'm more than capable of facing you alone, a smart man uses every advantage. And I am a smart man.
The intruder! The intruder is here! Everyone to me! Attack!
All better.
I cannot break him!
Nice lungs you've got there.
Mind your tongue, or I will cut it out!
Okay, I'm officially scared.
This is impossible. An unknown power must be shielding this man, which only confirms my suspicions. This Republic agent is the key to unlocking the threat we face. I must harness my rage and frustration. They will lead me to an answer.
Trust your feelings, Master.
The minion advises the master. Very good. You'll demonstrate your progress. And the word has spread that Lord Grathan is incensed at the slaying of his secret son. I take it that was your handiwork?
I didn't even break a sweat.
My confidence in you is growing. I haven't heard from Dykel Ball, my agent in Grathan's camp. He's missed a scheduled communication. Let me guess. He gave you trouble, did he?
I bled him dry and danced on his corpse.
No matter. He fulfilled his primary purpose. Every Sith must attempt to orchestrate his own promotion. Now, back to my prisoner. There's one last possibility to break him. I thought it impossible, but perhaps there's a small chance you could pull it off. Over a millennium past, the Emperor claimed Drummond Kass and made the Dark Temple the epicenter of Dark Force energy. In the bowels of the temple, he conducted horrifying experiments that drained the knowledge and life essence from all the greatest Sith Lords of the time.
Sounds like my kind of guy.
I'm sure that he would be relieved to hear that you approve. The Emperor created a device called the Ravager that ate his victims' minds and delivered to him their greatest secrets. No one could withstand the Ravager's intrusion. Even the strongest Sith Lords of the Empire confessed whatever the Emperor craved.
I'm sure the Emperor has the best toys.
I wouldn't call the Ravager a toy, Apprentice. It's not to be taken lightly. The Emperor keeps the Ravager hidden in the Dark Temple, which has, in his absence, become a death trap.
There's a good chance the horrors that await you will be too severe. But it's worth your life to me. The legends describe a secret chamber in the depths of the Dark Temple where the Ravager was encased. You'll know the device by its inscription. Be swift, Apprentice. I swear I will find a new apprentice if you do not make haste and search the Dark Temple for the Ravager immediately.
It was foolish of you to return here.
Uh-oh. Looks like we got another fight on our hands.
Those pieces you took from my minions belong to me. They will enable me to exact my revenge on Lord Farshall. I am Lord Vacuous, the conqueror of Begeron, the killer of Garatak the Singed. Return what you have stolen or burn.
I choose burn.
Die at the hands of Vacuous.
This always does the trick.
No!
when I sent you into the Dark Temple for the Ravager, I thought it might be the last time I saw you, apprentice. The prisoner grows weaker by the minute. There's no time to spare. Stand back and bear witness.
You're wasting your time. I will not.
Yes, the Ravager has seized his mind. Excellent. In his condition, we don't have long before the ordeal liquefies all brain matter.
I hope the results are gory and gruesome.
I do not care what we see as long as I hear what I want. Republic Worm, you have the information I desire. Tell me everything.
I am Republic Information Service, on special assignment to verify possible Imperial spy on Nar Shaddaa, commissioned by Jedi Council, acting on suspicions provided by Master Nomen Kar.
Nomen Kar. That's a name I grow tired of hearing.
Are you going to keep me in the dark, old man?
Nomen Kar is a Jedi Master who infiltrated the Sith. I rooted him out. Then he nearly destroyed me and fled. He's dedicated himself to proving that the Sith have spies embedded within Republic and Jedi ranks. I've thwarted him at every turn, but he is tenacious. How did Nomen Kar come to suspect my spy on Nar Shaddaa? Tell me, Republic wretch, what alerted him?
Master, Nomen Kar has a new Padawan. She seems to know any beings. True nature, she senses hidden darkness and untapped purity.
Astonishing. I've never heard of the Force granting such a gift. Tell me, how does her power work?
All I know is when Master Nomen Kar brought her to Nar Shaddaa, this Padawan sensed darkness in your spy simply by seeing him.
What's a Padawan?
That is what the Jedi call their trainees. It means she is not yet a Jedi. If this young Padawan can see through deception and disguise with such little effort, she threatens everything I have worked for. Continue, Republic dog.
Kar believes his Padawan's ability is foolproof. But the Jedi Council is skeptical. I was to provide the proof, but I wasn't able to report my findings.
We have to kill this Jedi in training.
Yes, my apprentice. Such a threat must not wander the galaxy unchecked. Who is this Padawan, you Republic pest? Tell me everything you know about her.
She was found on Alderaan. Her power first emerged, training on Tatooine. And Jedi sent another agent to investigate someone she suspected on Balmora.
He's fading. Is she human or one of the Jedi's cursed aliens? Where can I find her? What is her name?
I have nothing more.
The Ravager has emptied his mind. That is all we have to go on. A few random places within the greater galaxy where Nomen Kar and his Padawan have been.
It's a start, Master. That device did the trick.
You are correct. We now have leads to follow. Nomen Kar is a relentless crusader. This Padawan and her unprecedented power threaten everything I have achieved. Your duties are likely to take you to the far reaches of the galaxy. I will need to deploy you at will. You shall have a starship of your own. You've earned it.
Go to my personal hangar in the spaceport and claim it.
You bet I've earned it. This is long overdue, Barriss.
I'm the one who dictates the timing of such things. I must ponder our next move. Waste no time. Get your starship in my hangar and wait for further instructions.
Yeah, let's go before he tells me to clean all this up, okay?
Waste no more time. Go to my hangar in the spaceport and claim your starship. I will contact you with your new orders.
Wow. Take a look at that. We're going in style now.
Nice ship. A reward from your cowardly master for killing Lord Grethan's son?
You have a problem with that?
That's refreshing. I won't have to beat a confession out of you before I take your life. A true Sith thanks his foe for providing an outlet for his rage. My master wanted me to thank you before I killed you.
A true Sith lets his lightsaber do the talking.
You have guts. I'll give you that. I am Lord Grethan's top assassin. He sends me to eliminate those he wants to suffer the most. I'm here to kill you, friend, for murdering the son of my master.
Time to shut you up.
These are the last words you will ever hear.
All better.
Greetings. I am 2VR8, factotum droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
Do I seem gentle to you? Tell me your attack protocols, droid.
I was not constructed for violence, master, but I am still useful. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard this Fury-class Imperial Interceptor, a versatile craft combining a starfighter's maneuverability with armament to rival larger military vessels. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
Stop selling me the ship and stay out of my way.
I promise to limit all future conversation to essential information. Premature deactivation is not one of my directives. I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.